everyone. This is Tess of Quietess ASMR. Tonight we're going to be doing the first of a series of videos based on the four main elements in Western philosophy. They are fire, water, earth, and air. Tonight we're going to be going over fire. Basically, what I'm going to be doing in this video is I'm going to be lighting these matches. I can open them without making a whole bunch of noise. There we go. So I'm just going to be taking some of these matches and I'm going to be lighting them on the box. And I'll start off by naming a few random trivia about fire itself, going into some symbolism. And then once we go through that, I'm going to be guiding you through a fire-themed visualization to help you relax and decompress. So, let's begin. Let's see how successful I am with this. There we go. These matches aren't quite as long as I was hoping for them to be, but they'll do for tonight's focus. First, we're going over the definition of fire. According to, I think it was Wikipedia, I found this definition, but it is the rapid oxidation of a material in the exothermic chemical process of combustion. That lets off light, heat, and various reaction products, including water vapor. So by that very definition, fire is not actually a tangible thing. It's actually a chemical process. It's more of an event than a thing. Nonetheless, whether it's something more tangible or not, we're still pretty fascinated by it. Fire is also important for ecological processes of renewal, but it can also be very devastating, as we all know. For example, areas that experience wildfires, say a jungle or a forest, may benefit from this wildfire because wildfires actually leave byproducts in the soil of potassium. And I'm trying to remember what other chemical it was, but it's elements that are necessary for regrowth. It can clear away any deadfall that might have suffocated your growth. However, as is the duality of fire, sometimes it can cause more harm than good in this destruction. In the cases that if too much of a forest or wildlife area is burnt away, if too much vegetation is taken out by a fire, it can actually cause erosion because the vegetation isn't there to prevent excess erosion during rainfall, for example. And so then sometimes vegetation doesn't grow back. And as we all know, fire needs oxygen as one of its fuel sources in order to occur. And because of that, as far as we are aware, planet Earth here at home is the only place that fire occurs. As for the symbolism of fire, we often associate it with both power, destruction, renewal, and rebirth, such as the phoenix rising from the ashes. We can symbolize it with, or associate it, I should say, with aggression. But we can also associate fire with the warmth and gentleness, such as a home or the hearth, a cooking place, a candle. Colors most commonly associated with fire are red, orange, and yellow. We also know that the flame, the color of the flame, is affected by levels of oxygen that it's burning up, using for fuel. And also the chemical compounds and other elements that are being used up in the process of combustion. So, for example, on this match, as you can see at the bottom, it's more blue. Might be a little bit more green on film, I'm not sure. But it's generally more blue, maybe even a little purple. This is where the most oxygen occurs, and it's fresher. And as it goes up, the reason it turns yellow or orangey is because there's less oxygen and it's actually burning up more of the byproduct released at the base of the flame. We also know that sometimes certain chemicals give off different colors when they're burned in fire. For example, driftwood on a beach, if as all the salt and the algae can turn more bluish green. And I believe they now have in some camping sections at stores, they make specific, not sure if they're salts, but they are a type of chemical, non-toxic, from my understanding, that you can throw on your campfires to make them change color. Me personally, I just want to make a s'more over it. We also know that self-combustion is very real. There are some sources, such as old newspaper or compost, that result in self-combustion due to the processes of rot and the byproducts and elements given off during the process of rot and decomposition can actually cause self-combustion, which is why if you have any compost or a lot of old newspapers, they need to be disposed of in proper containers. Okay. So now, time. I'd just like to help you relax and go through a basic guided relaxation meditation, visualization, whichever word you prefer. As I continue to light these matches, I would like for you to do as I light each one of these matches, I want you to visualize that match as a problem, a stress, a worry that you've been carrying. Say you're having problems at work. And as the flame goes up the mat, consumes the little individual fibers of wood. Imagine all little stresses from work. Your boss is nagging. You have coworkers you can't get along with. You have clients or customers, appointments that are just not very cooperative or understanding. Maybe they just feel like, it seems like they're taking things out on you. It's just burning away. Maybe just a one bad day at your job. Whatever reason it is, maybe you had to work longer. Maybe you didn't feel very good and you just didn't really feel like working, but you had to for financial reasons. All that is burning away. Just burning away. every little flicker. Imagine the warmth. Feel the warmth of the match. So those problems just burn away. Maybe you're having problems with a relationship, romantic, friendship, or familial, or any other with a loved one. Maybe there's some communication errors. It's just being burnt away. The fire is igniting. And then slowly but surely dissolving the stresses, those worries, the stress. Maybe you're having a rough time at school. You have a teacher you just can't get along with. Maybe fellow students who just aren't very agreeable. Perhaps you're a little overwhelmed by your workload. These are all very valid things to feel. Now we're just gonna let the fire burn away all these stresses. We're going to let the flame rejuvenate us. We're going to let the flames from these matches replace the old stagnation. It's something new. There we go. We're going to allow the flame to let in new growth. We're going to allow it to bring in new, happier phases at work. We're going to let the flame leave behind the elements needed for better communication, for less stress, for better coping mechanisms. We're going to allow fire to give us the opportunity for something new, something better, for more peace, more contentment. Thank the fire for bringing us warmth, bring us kindness, maybe a little bit of romanticism. I'm going to thank the fire for its good qualities. Oh. on its duality. Knowing that we too can be both destructive and reconstructive. We can take away what doesn't serve us. Turn it into something better. And we can bring warmth, happiness, comfort into our lives. And all it takes is to just allow the idea to be struck, for the intent to fuel our decisions, to allow us to let go. Allow to feel that warmth throughout your body, starting at your toes, easily, gently reaching up your calves, your knees. Welcoming new happy change as the warmth spreads. Up your thighs, across your hips, your buttocks. Letting that warmth spread upward, the sense of feeling of comfort. A sense of your own power, up your back, your abdominals, stomach. Across your chest, up your fingertips, all the way up your hands, your palms, back of your palms, your elbows, up, 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 top of your back, your shoulders, up, 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 gently up your neck, across your chin, your cheeks, just focus on that warmth, the worries being burned away by your own fire, your own intention, your own inner flame. Feel its warmth all the way across your eyelids, your forehead. Gently spanning across your your scalp. Just relax and enjoy the warmth. Enjoy the gifts of fire. Thank you, everyone, so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it helped you to decompress and hopefully help you realize your own inner flame, your own potential. You guys have a wonderful evening or day, whatever time it is, where you are. Just remember to carry that flame of intent, that inner power with you. And as always, I will see you again. Bye-bye.